Hello, my name's Craig Earl, a market analyst at Alpari UK, and welcome to our daily market update. Trading volumes are much lower today. We've got the markets closed in the US for Martin Luther King Day. We've also had a lot of snow in the weekend over here in London, which can tend to impact traders' abilities to get into the office and can therefore again have an impact on volumes. However, with lower volumes, it tends to come increased volatility, so there should still be plenty of opportunities for you guys out there today in the markets. This week there's going to be a lot of focus on corporate earnings again. Last week the focus was mainly on the banks with Goldman Sachs and JP Morgan reporting. So this week it's going to be more on the tech companies. We've got Google and IBM reporting on Tuesday, but the one people are really going to be watching is going to be Apple on Wednesday. Now Apple has a significant weighting in the stock indices. It's got around a 10% weighting in the Nasdaq, and it's got around just under 4% weighting also in the S&P 500. So there's going to be a lot of focus on this, and with the stock actually having fallen around 30% or so since their highs last year, it would suggest there's going to be a lot of focus on here. There's been a lot of concerns about the iPhone 5 sales, which could have impacted fourth quarter earnings. So if we do see Apple actually beat these earnings, we could actually see a significant rise in the stock. Also, there'll be a lot of focus on the dividend. Now, we saw Apple last year announce its first dividend in a long time, and now we could actually see it increase its dividend, given the fact that we have seen this poor performance, we have seen the share price fall. It could encourage the directors to increase the dividend of Apple shares in order to encourage that as a way to try and boost that share price. The other major story today is the Bank of Japan meeting. Now that started earlier on this morning. We're due to get a rate announcement in the early hours of tomorrow morning, and also news about this asset purchase program. Now there's been a lot of speculation since Shinzo Abe came into power at the end of last year whether we'd see an increase in the inflation target from 1% to 2%, as well as further asset purchases. And there's also been rumors that we could see around 10 trillion yen of asset purchases announced tomorrow, as well as a commitment to unlimited bond buying until they hit that 2% inflation target. Now so far that has been responsible for that severe yen weakening and also the rally in the Japanese market. So if we see them miss that no commitment maybe to that 2% target or even lesser asset purchase than we are expecting, we could see a very negative reaction to this. So what does that mean for the yen? Well, if we take a look at the dollar yen charts first, you can see that over the last couple of weeks it has found significant resistance around that 90 level. That seems to be a key psychological level for the pair. If we do see a positive outcome from this Bank of Japan meeting, we could see it break this 90 level, potentially pushing on towards 95 before eventually reaching that 100 level again. I think that's going to be another very significant level for the pair. What's more likely though, in my opinion, is I think we are going to see a pullback, and there's a few reasons why we could see this. The first thing is, with the significant increase in the dollar yen over the last few weeks, over the last couple of months even, we could see the fact that this actual rate decision is already priced in, so we could see traders taking profit here, which would send the pair lower. We could also see no commitment from the Bank of Japan to unlimited asset purchase, despite the fact that it is priced in again, adding strength to the yen, weakening this pair. Also, we could see a smaller asset purchase program. We're expecting around 10 trillion yen of asset purchase, but if we see anything less than that, it'll be seen as a bit of a negative sign about the Bank of Japan about whether they are serious about hitting that 2% inflation target. Finally, in relation to that 2% inflation target, we may see no commitment to that. We may see them try to continue to avoid deflation, however, not actually stipulating that 2% inflation target. And I think there'd be a negative reaction to that again in the market. So I think there's a pretty good chance following this Bank of Japan meeting that we may actually see this pair slightly pull back. And that would be supported by those oscillators at the bottom. We can see the RSI and Stochastic are both significantly overbought at this stage. So that would support a pullback in the pair. But in the longer term, I'm still relatively bullish for this pair. I do think we're going to see a lot more asset purchases this year from the Bank of Japan in order to try and end this period of deflation with either an inflation target of 2% set tomorrow or at a later date. The other chart we'll take a look at is the Euro-Yen chart. Now we've seen a lot of activity here as well over the past few months. It's currently trading around that 119 area. Found resistance around 120 over the last couple of weeks, but we are starting to see a slight pullback here. And again, as I mentioned with that dollar yen chart, there's a lot of scenarios where we could envisage the pair starting to weaken and see a pullback in the pair over the next 24 hours or so, which would lead to further weakening over the next week or so. So I do expect to potentially see this pullback. I think it'll find support though around that 200 week moving average again. And I think because we saw that break above there a few weeks ago, so we could see it find support here, showing it as a new area of support before continuing that move higher. Again, I'm still relatively bullish for the pair in the longer term. I think we'll see resistance though over the next couple of weeks around that 123 area. That's a 38.2% retracement level, and then further above here again around that 50% retracement level around 132. For more news and analysis, check out the Alpari newsroom, which can be found at www.alpari.co.uk/newsroom. And you can also follow us on Twitter. My username is Craig_AlpariUK. And you can also follow the Alpari Twitter feed as well. That's AlpariUK4X. Thank you very much for listening. My name's Craig Earl, a market analyst at Alpari UK.